Hi! In this video, I will show you how to make a very cheap router resetter. In all these years, I have always had problems with hangups of my routers, which were supplied by internet providers. In all cases, a simple power off and on of the router solved the problem. If you experience the same problem, I have a simple solution for you. All costs are around 10 euros. Coming up! Welcome to my YouTube channel Green-Eyed Explorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics and house repairs. Intro. I decided to tell you a bit more about this device and explain what you can do with it. You can skip this section. But as always, your support is welcome in a way of hitting the like button, sharing video with your friends, asking me questions in the comments below and subscribing to my channel. As I drink buckets of coffee, I have even included a link in the description below if you want to buy me one. Support makes this channel go on. Well, let's start. Options. I will not go into details. Firstly, you will have to get the parts. Here we have two options. The easiest way is to buy a Sonoff S20 with the correct power plug for your country. The hardest way is to buy Wi-Fi enabled ESP8266 module, relay, power transformer, enclosure and wires. I chose S20 for less money and required time. Sonoff S20. Inside is a small circuit with mentioned ESP8266 processor and a relay. This device acts like a mains switch. Its basic feature with stock firmware is to switch any mains powered device from your phone. There are even some other firmwares like ESP Easy and Tasmota, which are very good for home automation systems. You can even use the device as a slow Wi-Fi repeater. My source code will be explained in the next part, but the code basically checks for internet connection and when there is none, it resets the router. At the moment of recording this video, I have found the best price for Sonoff S20 in the link in the description below. For this project, you will only have to set up Arduino environment and download my sources from GitHub. All the links are below. If you are new to microcontrollers, you can watch my tutorial on how to get started with ESP8266 in Arduino. Just click the link. Don't be afraid, no spooky things. Current version. I wrote a basic sketch. All you have to do is to enter your Wi-Fi name into SSID variable, a password for it into pass variable, and your network addresses. You can leave all other things untouched. The code loops and checks for the response from a predefined internet site every 5 minutes. If there is no connection, the next check will be after a half minute. If there is no connection for 15 minutes, the relay will go off and it will restart the router, wait few minutes for the router to initiate Wi-Fi, and lastly reset the Sonoff device and reconnect. The button on the enclosure functions as a reset button for your router. If you are a programmer and develop a better solution, just make a merge request on GitHub. Caution and programming preparation. Mains power can be lethal. The Sonoffs can only be programmed through serial if they are disconnected from mains. To put the unit into a programming mode, you have to press the button on PCB while connecting the 3.3 volts from serial port. In Arduino program, be sure to select the right device under the Tools board menu. For Sonoff S20, it should be generic ESP8266 module, flash size of 1 MB, SPFFS size does not matter as we do not use it. Here I have to mention the correct choice of flash mode. Every description on the net shows you have to set it to DIO. I found out mine works by selecting it as DOUT. Interchanging these two makes programming feasible, but the unit will not work. Leave other options untouched. On the PCB there are four unsoldered pins. The nearest to the transformer is ground. Connect your RX wire next to it. TX follows below. The furthest is VCC. Be sure to use a correct USB to serial converter. The ESPs are 3.3 volts, so use a 3.3 volts power supply and logic levels on converter. 5 volts power supply will kill your chip, 5 volts logic levels won't, but the programming might fail. Wi-Fi firmware update. After first serial programming described in the previous section, you are now able to upload your new firmware via Wi-Fi. You have to find device IP address. The IP address may not be identical as the one set in the code. DHCP may alter it if it is enabled. I implemented Service Discovery, alias SSDP. If it does not work on your computer, I recommend you to use an IP address scanner. For Windows users, I recommend Advanced IP Scanner, and for Android users, Fing. Both are free. See the links in the description below. After finding the IP, use a browser and enter the address. Select firmware update and then select .bin file and click update. Nice and fast. Demo and outro. I will not torture you with all the waiting in my code. I will only show you the manual reset by pressing the key. The light represents the router. Little work, but it surely makes all the router disconnection problems go away. Thank you for watching and see you next time. And don't forget to watch my other videos.